Hi, I've already turned a Raspberry Pi into a NAS and even my old laptop into an AI server. But today I'm doing something even crazier. Today I'm turning this old phone into a wireless NAS server. Okay, but what's a file server? You probably heard of Google Drive or Dropbox. This one is similar, but it works locally on your network. It's secure, private and costs you absolutely nothing. For me, perfect. And then I'm plugging this USB into a Wi-Fi router and turning that into a NAS. No coding, just chaos. I found this old phone into a drawer. Most people would recycle it, but I'm gonna make it useful again. This address is now my mini cloud. I can upload, download, stream files all over Wi-Fi. Okay, but how I do it? I just went to Google Play and installed this. Don't worry, it's a free app and it works fine for me. By the way, this isn't a sponsor video. I use this because it's good. Okay, once you open it, go to the network. Access from network. And I can choose random password and just start the service. That's it. Now you can just enter this here. Use the username and password from the phone. And yep, that's it. Now I can access file on my phone from any device on my network, from every phone, laptop and so on. As you can see, the phone isn't connected via USB to any computer. This is a great way to quick and easily create a file server for the entire network. It actually works. This old phone is now a file server. Insane. But that was just part one. What if I told you your Wi-Fi router can become a NAS too, with just USB stick? Yeah, of course, not all routers have USB ports, but if yours does, you're in luck, because you can have very cheap local file server. This $5 USB stick just became a home server. I'm currently sharing files on it. Okay, but how I do it? Of course, first I logged into the router to which I had previously connected my USB stick. This is important to check if your flash drive was detected. Here you should remember one thing, mounted point. Okay, now I can go to services, network shards. Okay, I will open it in a new tab for the faster access if I need it. As you can see, I don't even need to configure anything because the flash drive was automatically added to the shared directories. So I should have automatic access to it even without a password because allow guest options is selected. By the way, if you want, you can enter the usernames of the users who should have access to this resource here. Of course, each router configures differently, but you can usually find a quick guide in the user manual. Okay, back to the topic. If I want access to my flash drive connected to the router, I need to enter the router IP address and this name. Okay, let's see if this works. Router IP address and name. Perfect. But what about speed? Could this be useful? Let me try upload a file and see how long it takes. Okay, downloading from my NAS phone. And downloading from the router with my USB stick. Okay, let me change the name first. And as I mentioned, download the same file, but this time from the USB stick. As you can see, the speed isn't very fast this time either. Newer routers may have faster speeds. However, even this one is perfect for the text files and code, if you don't have the file server, of course. because if you do, the speed can increase dramatically. If this blew your mind, even a little, smash the like button. And if you want more insane tech hacks like this, make sure to subscribe. Don't miss the next one. Seriously, you won't believe what I'm doing in the next video. It's going to be even crazier. You won't want to miss it. See you there.